So bring yourself back down onto your mats. Let's ease our way down, starting our weekend or Wednesday stretch out. Beautiful, walking your heels in towards your bottom, and we'll just interlace the hands behind the head. So as you lay your head down, you've got your hands like a little basket supporting the head. Just point the elbows up towards the ceiling, and just a few inches, lift the head up very gently. And imagine you want to pull your hands towards the top of your head, so very gently elongate through the neck. And just begin to very calmly and quietly rock the head from side to side. So the theme of this class is to create some space. I'll talk a little bit more about that in a minute, but let's create some space in the neck, easing out tension in the shoulders. Coming back to center, chin very gently to chest. Again, that very calm and gentle upward thrust of your hands, lengthening the neck, and so you can tenderly place the head back down, keeping that length that you've created now, releasing the arms down alongside you. Arms up or down, whatever feels nice. Let's try and do the same for the lower end of the spine. So again, just hover the hips this time, just a few inches, not a full bridge, just hover the hips. A little tuck of the tailbone under, so you push the hips up towards the ceiling, feeling that lower back begin to lengthen out there. Try and keep that little pelvic tilt as you lower the hips down, and then release the tailbone down between the heels. Let's do that once more. So a little lift of the hips, a tuck of the tailbone under, try and lengthen out through the low back, and then release all the way down. And then from there, you can keep the knees pointing up towards the ceiling. You can walk your feet wider apart so your inner knees can then knock to touch. That's quite nice to support and ease any tension in the lower back. Closing the eyes. I'm just going to sit up for a moment so I can read to you just for a little bit as we begin our practice this morning. And I was thinking about the language of lockdown that we're hearing from all angles and on a daily, if not hourly basis. Words like confinement, isolation, lockdown. They're very negative, they're very powerful words. And I was wondering the psychological effect that those words will be having on all of us. And so what I want to try and think about this morning, rather than those very negative words, are words such as space, openness, expansiveness. And I've used a Japanese word for inspiration. And the Japanese word is ma. Ma. And ma has been described as a pause in time, an interval, or an emptiness in space. And the symbol for ma is the door and the sun. And together these symbols depict a door through the crevice of which the sunlight peeps in. We see in this symbol not only the outline of a door, but a door that's open to light, enabling growth, sparking creativity, permitting freedom. And this is Ma, the space between the edges, between the beginning and the end, the space and the time in which we experience life. Ma is filled with nothing but energy and feeling. It speaks of silence as opposed to sound, of lack as opposed to excess. It's the momentary pause in speech needed to convey meaningful words, the silence between musical notes. I feel that we've kind of entered a period of ma, kind of space between what was and what's to be. But really using that time, certainly on your mat, to create some space in what might be a very busy period. So many other and extra demands being placed on us during these extraordinary times. It's really nice to give us time in our practice. So let's bring that sense of space, first of all, to the physical body. So as you scan through the body this morning, just notice areas where you already feel quite open, quite spacious. already done a little bit to release around the upper back, around the lower back. You might have the palms turned up towards the ceiling so you can feel a sense of space and broadening across your collarbones. Nice spreading of your feet. Feeling the soles of the feet broadening down into the mat beneath you. And bring that same sense of space now to your breath. Beginning to deepen and lengthen each breath. And using the breath to really explore and open up those areas in the body that feel anything less than spacious this morning. Sending the breath to all those hidden crevices in the body, those passports of tension we might be holding today. So making sure that the brow is smooth. Imagine the space between your eyebrows broadening. Eyes softly closed. A little bit of space between your back teeth so the jaw is soft. We can apply that sense of space to our thoughts. So trying to let go of any thoughts that might be anything less than spacious, more confining, more restrictive. So that sense of space, it's more than just a physical sensation. So keeping with that sense of space throughout the practice, let's just bring the arms down alongside you, turning the palms down this time. Just walking your feet back in towards your bottom if you had your feet wide, so the knees point up towards the ceiling. Begin to lengthen your fingertips down towards your heels. We'll just start just by warming up and creating some space in the shoulders. So as you inhale, float the arms all the way up and over the top of the head so the back of the hands might touch the floor. And pause there in that first expression of openness through the sides of the body. You can take the arms out in a wide V or even alongside the shoulders if that feels more comfortable. Just soften down through the front of the ribs so you feel that you're not overarching through the back as you begin to lengthen and find space now just through the sides of the body. Open the palms, spread the fingers, find some space there. And then slowly, keeping the fingers spread, let's bring the arms all the way back down alongside you. Milu is desperate to get in. He's crying outside the door. He wants some space. Give me some space, Milu. Inhale, float the arms all the way up and back. Let's add a bit of movement now. And as you exhale, let's bring the hands all the way down alongside you again, just keeping the space between the fingers. Let's do that three or four more times. So keeping the rest of the body open and soft, just working into lengthening up and out through the sides of the body, beginning to connect with that open and spacious breath this morning. So as you inhale, we keep the shoulders away from the ears, keep that space as you bring the arms back, upper arms alongside the ears or in an open V shape, keeping that space in the shoulders. Let's do it just once more. So inhale, let the arms all the way up and back. This time as you exhale, bring the arms down and then bring the knees in towards the chest, holding onto the knees. Just begin to rock or circle the knees, creating some space in the low back. Rock the head away from your knees. That's nice. That's a little bit of gentle self-soothing massage there. Lovely. And then coming back to center, just crossing one ankle over the other, widening the knees, catching hold behind your knees. So if this isn't for you, roll to one side and just come and join us on all fours. But if it's okay, just start a few rocks. So just beginning to rock up and down through the spine. Ah, little massage out. You might be pausing at the top. Let's do one more big rock to bring you all the way up to seating. Tuck the toes to one side. And we'll come on to all fours. Yes, I apologize for any animal intrusions. He's not giving me any space today. So as you find your way onto all fours, let's just pick up the right hand for a moment. Give it a little shake. I find that I'm spending more time at the computer, so let's just create a little bit of space in the wrist. And then hover the hand just off the mat, nice and broad with the palm there. And place the hand down under the shoulder so you've really created some space, pressing down into your knuckle pads across the palm. And then we'll do the other side. So picking up the other hand, maybe
a good old shake, releasing any tension from the wrist up through the arm into the shoulder, and then spreading the fingers again, nice and wide. Hand just hovers, keeping the space between the fingers. Let's bring the hands down and just making sure that the shoulders are above your wrists and trying to keep them there as we come to a little cat-cow. So we'll dip the belly down, feeling that lovely arching of your back. Try not to constrict the back of the neck, so keep the space. Chin just level with the floor as you take a nice inhale. And exhale, angry cat, like my cat outside the door, rounding on up. So as you continue to roll with your breath, inhaling, head and heart lift, just make sure that the weight doesn't start to shift back, especially as you round your back. We've sometimes got a temptation to begin to shift the weight back so the shoulders kind of come behind the wrists. So really trying to keep them above the wrists, and that way we can find some more space between the shoulder blades. Lovely. So you might just want to stay here this morning. Or you might want to add a little bit of flow, creating that space through the sides of the body. So as you inhale, you lift the head and the heart. And as you exhale, round the back and just sit the sit bones back towards your heels. And then inhaling, coming forwards and up. So you get the sense of stretching the chest forwards and up. And then really getting that space in the lower back and upper back, tuck tailbone under. Just a couple more like that. If you want to stick just by staying on all fours without the shifting of the weight, feel free to do that. Let's do that once more. All the way forwards and up if you're with me. And then rounding all the way back. And just pause there. So let's all meet there in that child pose. It's quite an active child pose. So really get that rounding of the back. Come up onto fingertips and see if you can push your finger pads forwards and down, creating that space right underneath the armpits there. Beautiful. And then as you flatten the hands, we'll make our way back onto all fours. And just thumb up through the belly. So push the hands into the floor. A little bit of navel to spine action there as you slide your right leg back. So we feel supported from the underneath. Ball of the foot to the floor. And as you push your hands down, really bring your navel up towards your spine. Kick the heel back. Find that nice space in the back of the knee. You can keep still. You can add slow rock. So nothing ballistic or fast about that movement if you are adding that little rocking backwards and forwards. Lovely. And then coming to stillness, opening up through the back of the knee. Now pick up your left shin. Have a little swish on the knee. So you're turning the shin off the mat. So you're turning to face a long edge of the mat, reaching the right arm up, trying to push the little toe edge of that right foot to the floor as you come into a little side plank. I can see lots of arms there, beautiful. So again, shoulders over wrists, so that supporting arm. Take a nice inhale as you reach up. And as you exhale, the arm comes alongside the ear, so you're getting that nice sense of space all through the right side of the body. Hips push forwards if you feel the bottom is beginning to sag back. Lovely. Reaching and lengthening all the way back. Beautiful. And then coming back onto all fours, hands under shoulders, knees under hips, ready for those three little variations of our thread needle, starting with the one that we know. So right arm, let's take the right arm all the way up towards the ceiling, turning the chest, take an inhale, and exhale, we feed the hand through, hand hovers, trying to stretch the fingertips away from you. Turning the chest, reaching up as you inhale, finding that space across the chest. And then stretching your arm underneath. If you're moving faster or slower than me, don't worry. Last one, inhale. And this time the back of the hand comes to the floor and we'll slide the hand away from you, coming down onto the side of your shoulder, side of your head there. Now we can settle on in there, so just take a moment to get comfortable. You can keep the left hand by your face and just lean into that right shoulder a little bit. So you shift the weight into the right shoulder. Or you bring that left arm forwards, catching hold of the outside edge of the mat. And as you tug the mat away from your face, you lean to the right. So mat pulls away from your face and you lean into that right shoulder. So you might find that you feel a little bit of deeper stretch going on in the shoulder there. Lovely. And then very slowly, we'll bring the right, left hand by your face. Push the floor away. As you inhale, let's take the right arm all the way up. And this time as you exhale, we'll feed that right arm underneath the body so it stretches to the outside of the left knee, outside of the left knee. I'm going to turn my head to look towards my left hand again. Whoa. Coming down onto the side of the shoulder, stretching the fingertips away from you. So you might find a stretch on the top of the shoulder there. Lovely. And the last one, we come all the way up, sweeping the right arm up. And this time we take the right arm over on the diagonal to the left-hand corner of the mat. I'm going to tuck my toes, come up onto my fingertips, and sink back towards my heels, so I'm getting that nice sense of space to stretch through the left side of the body. Lovely. If that's too much, you can always just bring the weight forward a little bit so you're not sinking so far back towards your heels. Beautiful. And then slowly, slowly, let's make our way back onto all fours, hands under shoulders, knees underneath the hips. As you inhale, let's lift the head, lift the heart. And as you exhale, round on up like that angry cat. Beautiful. And then we'll try all of that on the left side. So firm up through the belly, take the gaze forwards as you slide the left leg back this time, all of the foot to the floor. So you're trying to open up the back of the knee towards the ceiling. You might want those little rocks back and forth. Keep it nice and slow so you're not risking hurting the back of the leg, the calf, the Achilles. It's the last thing we want to do in these times. And then again, pushing the floor away, firm up through the belly, really stretch up through the back of the leg, create the space. And then we pivot on the right knee. So you take the shin off the mat, turning to the left, you reach the left arm all the way up towards the ceiling, reaching the arm up, push the hips forwards as you extend up. As you inhale, reach up. And as you exhale, you can take that top arm all the way forwards, lifting your ear towards your upper arm. And try and bring the little toe edge of that left foot down towards the floor there. So you're getting that nice stretch up through the left seam of the body, create that sense of space. And the side of the foot all the way through to the fingertips. Lovely, and then coming back down onto all fours. So those three versions of thread needle, this time left arm leading. So reaching the left arm up, look up towards the fingertips if that's comfortable. Take an inhale. Exhale, we feed the arm through. So we're gonna move with the breath for the first couple. So inhale, we turn the chest, create that space across the chest. Exhale as you feed the arm through again, reaching the fingertips away from you. Last time, all the way up. And this time the back of the hand slides off the mat. We'll hold this next one. So take a moment there just to ease yourself down nice and gently, side of the head, top of the shoulder. And take a little shift of the body weight into the left, so lean to the left. Right hand might stay where it is, or you take hold of the side of the mat. And as you pull the mat away from your face, you lean into that left shoulder. So again, you might feel there's a little bit more energy going on with that stretch. If that's not for you, keep the hand by the face. Lovely. And then slowly, slowly, we'll all bring the right hand down by the face. So you can sweep that left arm all the way up, coming to that little diagonal stretch. So this time we feed the arm underneath the body to the outside of the right knee. Again, I'm going to turn my face to the right, bringing myself down onto the top of the shoulder. And again, you might just want to lean a little bit into that left shoulder. Lovely. So you're finding maybe a different stretch into the shoulder there. And the last version, so push into that hand, reach the left arm all the way up. And this time we arc it over to the right, so it's coming on a diagonal, up on tented fingertips, tuck the toes, shift the hips back. And you can make a little platform, I forgot that on the other side, you can make a little support for your head as you bend your underneath arm, if that feels comfortable. Lovely, feeling again that nice sense of space all the way down into the armpit. Slowly rise up. Nearly gone suspiciously quiet, which always worries me. Let's bring the hands underneath the shoulders, tuck the toes, let's sit back towards your heels, getting ready for a downward dog. If that's not for you, stay on all fours. So slowly, slowly, let's just pick up the knees and slowly unfurl into that sense of space, creating that space in the back of the legs. Begin to slowly walk out the feet. Lovely, bending one knee and then the other. Just give the head a little shake or nod just to release tension there. And did you find your downward dog today? Find a bit of stillness there now. So bend the knees generously. Just send your ribcage back towards your thighs. And then from there, almost imagine you want to send your pubic bone up towards the ceiling between the legs. You're trying to lengthen that through the low back. Quite often we round the low back there. So again, almost imagine you're trying to tilt your hips up and back. And with your hands, imagine there's an outward fanning of your hands from your thumb outwards towards your little finger. So you might feel that your armpits begin to close a little bit, creating that space between your shoulder blades. Lovely. Space through the back, space between the ear and your shoulder there. Lovely. And then bending your knees generously, look forwards as you sit back towards your heels, and then spring step or help your right foot forwards and drop the back knee. Lovely. I'm going to flatten my back foot as I rise up into that low crescent lunge, so sweeping the arms all the way up. And then as you begin to just have a little play with that, so you might begin to drop the left hip forwards and begin to arc the body gently back. I'm going to hook one thumb over the other. Drop the shoulders down, but pull the thumbs apart. Imagine you want to pull your thumbs apart so you might feel that there's a sense of space across the shoulder blades. Lengthen all four sides of the waist, so make sure you're lifting out of the hips, softening through the rib cage. You're not sinking down into the floor, so push the floor away with that front foot. There's a lot going on, even though it's a relatively simple pose there. Beautiful. Take one more inhale. And as you exhale, let's release the hands down, coming again onto those little tented fingertips. Tuck the back foot under, and keeping the chest lifted, just begin to shift the top of that left hip down. Lovely. And then keeping a little bend in that right knee, we'll shift the weight back. Sole of the foot stays on the floor, finding some space in the hamstring now. Inhaling, rock the weight forwards, lift the chest, so we're getting a little stretch in the top of the left hip. Exhaling. It comes back, foot to floor, softness in the knee. So as you roll with the breath, you can start exploring whether you can bring your toes towards your face, or you might want to keep a bend in the knee. Try to keep the chest open as you rock forwards. It's very easy to kind of compress in the chest, get that sense of space. And this next one is pause and hold. So as you shift the weight back, you might slide that front heel even further away from you, push the heel down. Pull the toes towards your face, or you can use the right hands to cup the toes and draw the toes back towards you. So you're getting a stretch and space all down the fascia of the feet, as well as the back of that right leg. Oh, that feels quite nice today. Lovely. And then slowly, slowly the foot comes down. Let's pick up that back knee and step back into your downward facing dog. Beautiful. And from your downward dog, let's take a roll forwards to plank. So again, shoulders above wrists, looking forwards, knees down. And keep that space through the chest as you lower yourself all the way down to the mat. Flattening the feet, taking the feet a little wider apart there. Hands come off the mat, fingertips level with the shoulders, and elbows point up towards the ceiling like a little robot. Let the head hang as you push into your fingertips, keel the chest up into a really easy cobra. And then just lifting the head so the chin is parallel to the floor. And then stretch the front body all the way down. So it's really slow and easy. Inhaling, head hangs, push into fingertips, roll up, lengthening toes away, lifting the chin. Exhale, so lengthen all the way down. Almost imagine you're creating space from navel to the throat. Last time, all the way up. Little open-hearted cobra. Exhaling down. This time we bring the feet hip width, hands under the shoulders, push up all fours. You can stay there or tuck the toes. Find that downward facing dog. I've just seen it's raining, that's why he's crying. Have that little pedal out again, crying, trying to create that sense of space. Pause in that downward dog. So again, to tilt your tailbone up towards the ceiling. I'm just going to put someone on mute. I think someone's just popped off mute for a while. So again, imagine that you're... There we go, sending your pubic bone up towards the ceiling. So you're trying to open up that space in the low back. That outward fanning of your hands, thumb towards the little fingers. So you're closing the armpits, creating that space across the upper back. And then bending the knees deeply, sit back towards your heels, look forwards, and then step, spring, or help the left foot forwards. And drop the back knee. Beautiful, flattening the foot, finding Anjayasana, that lovely low lunge. So if you can remember, you're going to hook the thumbs the opposite way. It's the way that will feel innately very strange. So drop the shoulders, but imagine pulling the thumbs apart so you feel a little bit of work in the upper back. Again, you can begin to just shift the weight forwards if that feels comfortable. Lift and open up through the chest, lengthening all four sides of the waist. So really lifting up and out of the hips there, pushing the floor away. Lovely. Beautiful. Take one more inhale and then exhaling down onto those little tented fingertips. Frame the foot, tuck the toes. And again, as you shift the weight back, we'll keep a softness in the knee and the foot to the floor. And then as you shift the weight forwards, really lift the chest, dropping the top of that right hip down. Lovely. So So just rolling back and forth. So you can stay here, or you can begin to explore straightening the leg, pulling the toes towards the face. Again, coming back to that lovely sense of space as you rock forwards. Oh, this feels quite nice today. And then this time we'll sit back and pause. So option foot to floor, knee bent, or slide that front heel away from you. Maybe cup the foot with that left hand. As you pull the toes towards your face, you push the heel down. So you're getting that sense of space and stretch in the foot as well as the back of the leg. But we'll all be very different there, so entirely up to you. Lovely. And then again, foot comes down. Going to pick up the back knee, stepping back onto all fours or joining me downward facing dog. Lovely long spine. Inhale as you wave the body forwards to plank. Knees lifted or knees down, that sense of space through the front body as you come all the way down. Lovely. Flattening the feet again, a little wider than hip width. Space between the legs, hands off the mat. Fingertips plugged into the mat, hanging cobra. Inhale, rise up, head hangs. Pushing the hips down, lifting the chin at the top of the inhale, and then exhale, slowly rolling down twice more. So it doesn't matter how high you come up, get a sense of lengthening the toes away from you. So we're keeping that sense of space in the lower back. Last one, so, uh-oh. He's in. This could all go horribly wrong. Hands alongside the shoulders. Oh, you monster, come on to all fours. And find a downward dog. You're not supposed to be in this room. Take a little pedal out with the feet. Oh no, you beast. Right, I'm gonna face the other way, so I'm on the right leg, and this could all go horribly wrong. No, we're not gonna play on the family. Oh, this never happens to Joe Wicks. This time we're gonna find a three-legged dog, not a cat. So we're gonna take the right leg all the way up and back. Lovely. And then bending the knee, step, spring, or help right foot forward. Mina, you're going to have to go. You're right in the middle of my mat. Come on. Never work with children and animals. Off you go. Thank you. Oh, right foot down. And before you bring that back knee down, slide that left leg back a little bit. So when you bring the knee down, it's well behind your hip. Well behind your hip. Lovely. Flatten the foot. Both hands to the inside of that right foot. And just walk the right foot slightly out to the right, turning the toes out ever so slightly, and allow the knee perhaps to swing open. So you're feeling a little sense of space in the hip. And then just begin to circle the hips there. Circle the hips. Yeah, so it might be big movement, might be small. And then just try the opposite way, seeing how that hip feels. Again, if you're spending a lot of time sitting down at your computer, maybe not moving quite so much during the day, so the hips might feel a little stiff. And then we're coming just to stillness, dropping the top of the left hip down. Lovely. And then bring the right hand to the inside of the right knee and gently push the knee away from you and turn the chest up towards the ceiling. So the right knee's being pushed away very gently and you're turning the chest up towards the ceiling. And then bringing the right hand to your heart, turn your chest up towards the ceiling as you reach that right arm all the way up towards the ceiling. Take an inhale. And as you exhale, sweep that arm forwards and down, really stretching it away. Inhaling, reaching the arm up, so you're turning the chest. And exhale, reach that right arm forwards and down. Lovely. Just once more. So the hand comes across the chest, reaching up towards the ceiling. And this time as you bring both hands down to the floor, finding that little version of lizard pose, so you can keep both hands just to the floor. You can come up onto fists if that's more comfortable. If you're quite open in the hips today, you might come down onto your forearms. And if you're coming down onto your forearms, make sure that you've not kind of really rounded the back there and that you're not leaning into one forearm more than the other. So that's quite a tough one for hips. Allow that right knee just perhaps to swing open. And those of you who want a little bit more in the hips, you can tuck your back toes under. Lift the left knee so you're stretching the hip away, stretching the knee away from you, so you're getting that nice openness in the front of the hip. That's really strong, so it's not going to be for everyone. If you want to bring your knee down, please feel free. You've really got to be in control of your own bodies here. If you're with me, you've got that knee lifted. Let's bring the knee down. Coming up onto your hands if you're onto your forearms. Ooh, walking that foot back into the middle of the mat. Now pick up the back knee and adjust that back foot for a warrior two. So the heel turns in, toes turn out, lining up heel to arch. So as you roll your way up into that warrior two, arms out nice and wide. Ah, beautiful. It's like animal crackers here today, isn't it? Beautiful. So making sure that you've got your front knee stacked over the ankle and it's not rolling in. So squeeze it out towards the little toe. And then turning the front palm up, we'll reach up and back. So getting that delicious openness and space all the way through the right side of the body. Little flow here. So keep the left hand where it is, but bring the right forearm down to your thigh, side ankle. And then that left arm sweeps forwards and up, bringing you back into that warrior two. So a little flow. Inhale, take the right arm up. Exhaling, forearm to thigh. Left arm sweeps forwards and up as you inhale. Exhale back into your warrior two. So just working with your breath now. Lovely sense of space through the front body. Exhale, leaning forwards and down. Sweeping that arm up. So getting that lovely space across the chest back into your warrior two. Let's do that once more. Inhale. Oh, that feels quite nice after Joe Wicks this morning. Exhale. Lots of squats this morning. Inhaling up. And we're all meeting that lovely warrior two. Lovely. You can stay here. You can just lift up and out of the hips, bending and straightening that front leg if that's more than enough for you today. Or if you want a little bit more, interlace the hands around the low back. Draw the knuckles down, open through the chest. Take a nice inhale and exhale. You send the chest to the inside of that front thigh. So you're leaning down on the diagonal, reaching the arms back behind you. Lovely. So try and lift up and out of the hips again. We're not collapsing there, so knuckles drawing you back. Beautiful. Bringing the hands down to frame the foot. Take a little twizzle on that back foot so the heel is up. And slide that right leg all the way up and back into a three-legged dog. Extend the leg up. And then lower the foot down. A little vinyasa or take a child pose or all fours. Inhale, roll forwards to plank. Exhaling, knees lifted or lowered. Keep that space through the front body. Flatten the feet, hands alongside the shoulders. Into that cobra. Or take that open-hearted cobra we did before. Exhale to lower. Let's do once more. So option to take the hands wide, keeping that space across the shoulders. Inhaling up. Exhaling down. This time as you inhale, let's come back up onto all fours. And exhale, pause for a moment in that child pose. Sending the hips back towards the heels. You can part your knees slightly if that's more comfortable. Again, create a little bit of space for your belly. Lovely. And while we're here, let's nudge our hips to the left and just walk both hands over to the right-hand side. Hands might be apart. You can stack one on top of the other, but try and have an evenness across your upper back. So drop that left armpit slightly if you feel that you've lifted it up towards the ceiling. And as you sit back towards that left heel, breathe some space into the left side of the body. Just imagine you're breathing into that left lung. Nice, and then we'll come all the way back through center, squaring off hips and arms, and then bottom to the right, hands over to the left, hands apart, or one on top of the other. Again, the choice very much is yours. Dropping that right armpit down ever so slightly, so you're not opening up across the upper back. You've got a nice balance across the upper back there. Beautiful. Breathing into that right lung. And then we'll come all the way back through center. So you can work from all fours or joining me from all fours, tucking the toes, finding that downward dog. We'll do that little flow on the left leg. So bringing the right foot to the middle of the mat, left leg lifts up and back behind you. And then step, spring, or help that left foot forwards. And before you bring the right knee down again, slide that right leg back. So when the knee comes down, it's well behind your hips. So we're getting that nice hip opener. Hands to the inside of the foot. Just scoop the left foot out to the left a little bit. You can turn the toes out if that's comfortable. And again, just do those little circles with the hips. So you might start to kind of roll around on that front foot a little bit. And this is my stiffer side. I can instantly feel that this side is stiffer. Next, we think about how I sit, how I cross my legs. Let's be doing the same thing over and over again. Lovely. And then we'll bring the body to stillness. Bringing the left hand to your left knee. So you gently push the knee away from you, turning the chest up towards the ceiling. So there's no sense of forcing here. Be really easy on the hips. And then reaching that left arm all the way up towards the ceiling. Get that space from fingertip to fingertip across the chest. Take an inhale. And as you exhale, we reach that left arm forwards and down. And then inhale, you sweep the arm across the chest all the way up towards the ceiling, reaching on the diagonal. Exhale, forwards and down. So we're getting that nice stretch into the hips and across the back. Once more, all the way up. And this time we'll bring both hands down. Ready for that lizard pose. So you might have the hands quite high and the chest quite lifted. Or you might be able to drop down onto one forearm and then the other. Making sure again that you're not leaning more heavily to one side or the other. So it'll all be very different in terms of hips. And that last little bit, if you want the extra stretch, you tuck the back foot under, lift the knee and drop the hips down. So you're getting that real sense of openness through the top of that right hip. That's not going to be for everybody by any means. So really listen to what's going on in the hips today. Ooh. Lovely. And then if you're with me and you've got the knee lifted, we'll lower the knee. If you're on your forearms, come back up onto your hands so you can bring that left foot to the middle of the mat. Lifting the back knee, adjusting that back foot, so lining up your heel, front heel with the back arch, or thereabouts. Finding your way up into that warrior two, so nice and wide with the arms, and take a moment there to make whatever adjustments you need. You might need to slide that front foot forwards a little bit so your knee is above your ankle. Maybe lift the shoulders up and then roll them down so you keep that space between ear and top of shoulder. Lovely, breathe, nice and broad with the arms. And then as you turn the front palm up, we get that lovely sense of space through the left side of the body as you reach to the wall behind you. Keep the right arm where it is, but bring the left forearm down to your thigh. And then that right arm takes a big circle forwards and up, all the way back into your warrior two. So inhale, we sweep left arm up and back. Exhaling, left forearm to thigh. Inhaling. Right arm sweeps forwards and up, carrying you back into that warrior two. Let's do that a couple more times. Lovely. So creating that space across the chest. Last one. If you've had enough, just pausing in your warrior two, catching your breath. And that's where we'll all meet now in that lovely warrior two, broad across the chest. You might just want to stay there, just bending and straightening the front leg, particularly if you're kind of new to yoga today. Or interlace the hands around the low back, draw the knuckles down, and then we direct the chest to the inside of that front line, front thigh, humble warrior. So the arms are lengthening back behind you, pushing the floor away with that front foot so we're not collapsing. Uh-oh, he's back. Hands frame the foot. Take a little pivot on the back foot so the heel is up towards the ceiling, and then take the left leg all the way up and back into that three-legged dog. Last little flow, bring the foot down. Option, take a child pose or inhale, roll forwards to plank. Exhale, knees lifted or lowered all the way down. Beautiful, flattening the feet, inhaling into your cobra. Might be arms wide, might be head hanging. Exhale, lower, we'll do once more. So option again, hands off the mat. Fingertips plugging into the earth, elbows high. Lovely, all the way down. Hands alongside the shoulders, let's push up onto all fours. And this time, widening the knees, big toes point towards one another. Take a sit back towards your heels and extend the arms out nice and long. Lovely. You can stay here. Or that last little stretch for the shoulders, just feed your left arm underneath the right. So you're coming into a nice gentle release, it's much softer than the other one that we did before. Let the back of the hand rest on the mat. Uh-oh, he's back. Oh, Milu, you are terrible. Ah, I'm going to need some yoga after this. It's so stressful. All the way back through centre, Milu. And this time without a cat shoving his bottom in your face. Thread your right arm underneath the left. Oh, he's doing it with me. Oh, well done, Milu. If you stay there, that might be okay. Lovely. And then slowly let's stretch the arms out. Walking the hands back towards your knees. You're sitting up on your heels. Point both knees forwards. Drop the bottom to one side. I'm going to come and face you. And pretend that my cat is not wrecking this practice. Stretching the legs out. You can't see him now. He's sort of behaving himself. So we're going to take the right leg out on the diagonal. And bring the left heel in towards your groin. So sometimes we kind of drop back towards the back of the pelvis there. So make sure you're sitting up nice and tall. Oh, please don't bite my toes. Don't bite my toes. Please be good. So sitting up nice and tall. We're going to come into a little bit of flow. So the option is always to keep your bottom down on the floor. So left hand comes down behind the hip. Just sweep the right arm across the body. An option to roll to the inside edge of the foot and push the hips up towards the ceiling. What you can do, what Milu's doing, just roll around. And then we lower the hips all the way down and take a forward fold over that extended right leg. So hand sweeps behind as you inhale, right arm lifts up, hips push forwards. And as you exhale, lower the hips and we take a little fold over that extended leg, lovely. So just working with the breath, you can keep the hips down and just work the arm if that's more comfortable for you today. And then lower down. So last one, inhale, rising up, pushing the hips forwards and up. And then coming all the way down. And this time we're going to hold in that forward fold. So you might need to draw that right hip back ever so slightly, trying to sway your chest up over that extended leg. Your hands might be close to you. And the body quite far away from your thigh. Or those of you more open in the back and the hamstrings might be folding a little further forwards. And again, if you want a little more, you might want to cross at the wrists and take hold around the inner and outer edges of your feet, of your foot, and draw yourself forwards and down. Lovely. Let the breath be long. Try and keep that space open through the chest. So Milu's done his usual, coming in, show off, and then go away again. Lovely. Slowly, slowly release. Come all the way back through centre. And just make sure again that you're sitting up nice and tall on your sit bones. You can always pop a cushion or a pillow underneath your bottom. And bring your hands down in front of you. Toes of that right foot point up towards the ceiling. And take a little forward fold there. Now what tends to happen is that your right bottom will lift up off the floor. So try and keep your right buttock pressing down into the mat. So it's not a great fold forwards for many of us if we can keep that anchor point. So we're trying to create that space in the hip, in the inner thigh, but keep that space through the chest. Lovely. So keep the weight heavily in that right bottom. I can feel I'm beginning to lift mine up, chest square to the front. Lovely. Walking the hands back towards you. And bring the back of your right hand to your shin or your thigh. And take the left arm up and over. So having created that sense of space, let's make the most of it now by arcing the arm all the way up. And then just back off. So just release that left arm all the way down. So coming all the way up and over. Sliding the right hand towards the foot. Keeping the chest nice and open. And then just backing off that stretch, let it go. So this next time we'll pause and hold. So as you reach that top arm overhead, really get that sense of turning the chest up to the ceiling. Now this top arm, if it's not comfortable hanging there, you can either bring the hand behind the head, push the head into your hand and point the elbow to the ceiling, or just let that hand wrap around the low back. Those of you more open might wrap the first two fingers around the big toe, drawing yourself down over that leg. So we'll all be in very different spaces, being really mindful of what's going on in side of the body, the low back, the chest and the shoulders. Slowly, slowly release. Let's just bring both hands behind you so you can stretch both legs out, give them a little bit of a shake. And bringing your feet to where your knees were, fingertips facing in towards you or angled out. Let's push the floor away, lift up through the chest, finding that space across the heart. Option to stay there, or a little upward plank as you inhale, lift the hips, bringing the bottom level with the backs of your knees, and exhale, lower all the way down, lovely. So twice more, rolling the shoulders, option to lift the hips or simply keep the hips down and expand and open through your chest. Slowly lower all the way down, lovely. Last one, roll the shoulders, lift the chest. Mila, you must be very bored. And then come all the way down, lovely. So this time we'll try that little sequence on the other leg. So this time we've got the left leg extended, right heel into groin. So again, make sure that you're sitting up on your front of your hips there, that you're not rolling back and rounding into the back. So this time it's the right hand that comes behind you. So you roll onto the inside edge of that left foot as the left arm sweeps forwards and up, maybe pushing the hips forwards. And then slowly as you lower the hips, we take a little forward fold over that extended leg. So as we inhale, that left arm, yes, Milu, sweeps all the way up. And exhale, we turn the chest and we're beginning to explore that little forward fold. So twice more. You're doing it with me, Milu. I'm not doing a very good sleepy cat this morning. More of a wrecking, showy off cat. You did the last one with me. All the way up. So this next time we'll pause in that forward fold. So bringing the chest square over that extended left leg, you might need to draw the hips slightly back. Again, the hands might be quite close to you. You might have the belly quite close to the thigh. You might have the wrists crossed, holding up around the outer and inner edge of the foot. So you're drawing the body down by gently widening the elbows. So again, no forcing. Slowly, slowly let the body melt down. Lovely. And as you ease your way back up to center, so this time you turn your hips and your chest, you're square between the legs. Again, just making sure that you keep your left buttock anchored down and the toes pointing up towards the ceiling. We come into that little forward fold, so it's not going to be particularly deep for many of us. Especially if you do keep that bottom on the floor, we tend to lift the bottom up. So I can feel that all the way through the inner seam of my leg, really pushing the heel away from me to keep myself grounded and open through that left leg. Easing your way down. Nice, and then as you rebuild your spine, walking your hands back towards you, let's come into that little side stretch, the back of the left hand just on your thigh or your shin, and reaching that right arm up, really keep the chest open as you reach the arm overhead, so don't worry about reaching your toes, some of you might get there, I'm not going to. And then we back off, so we just allow the body just to come back up through center. And then we'll try that again. So you're sliding the hand towards your foot, arcing the body all the way over, and then come all the way back through center. Lovely. So this next time, you might just want to hold there. So again, option to hook the big toe with your first two fingers, drawing yourself down a little deeper. Option to release the hand back behind you. You can look down, hand behind the head, pushing the head into your hand, elbow points up towards the ceiling, so you've got that sense of space through the side body. All of those variations really tailor it to what's going on in your body today. Lovely. Slowly, slowly release. Hands come behind you so you can swing the legs out, giving them a little shake. So we've got the option to keep the legs straight this time, or bend the knees and bring your feet back to where your knees were. Or even just do it with one leg. There's a good little halfway house. Have a little play with that. And then come into that upward facing plank again. So hands behind you, fingertips pointing forwards or angled out. Roll the shoulders, lift the chest. And we've got the option again to lift the hips. If you're with me with the legs extended, you're pointing all 10 toes, including the big toe, down towards the floor. Try not to drop the head too far back as you slowly lower the hips down. If you were doing that with one leg bent, Change legs, and we'll do that again. So roll the shoulders, lift the chest, push the hands to the floor, option to stay there. Or again, lifting the hips, all 10 toes pointing towards the floor, they might not get there. And then slowly lowering the hips. Setting yourself up nice and tall, maybe a soft bend in the knees, reaching up and out of the hips. Take a nice inhale and exhale, just extend and offer the body forwards and down. Just releasing the hands wherever they fall. They might be alongside the shins or the thighs. Keeping space for the breath there. You might just allow your head to hang and take a little rock of the head side to side, just letting the head go, releasing any tension in the neck. You might be able to walk your bottom back away from your heels, creating more space in the low back for you to fold forwards. Let's take a couple of easy breaths there. Forward folds again help almost mark that transition from a movement-based practice now to that slower, more inward journey towards Shavasana. When you're ready, just walk your hands back towards you, bending your knees, bringing your heels back towards the bottom. Ease your way back down onto your mats. If you're in a cooler room today, just notice it's raining. You want a little blanket to hand, then just have it nearby, pillow nearby, whatever you need. And let's just ease our way down onto our backs. A little twist to finish. Bring the arms out shoulder height. Really find that space across the chest as you reach both fingertips away from you. Take your feet wide. So let's take the feet towards the outside of the mat. Just begin to tip the knees from side to side. A very gentle twist. So really nice just to release the hips by keeping the feet a little wider apart. And you can play with how close your heels are towards your bottom. So if your hips feel really tight today, just walk your feet a little further away from your bottom. If you want a deeper twist, you bring your heels, keep your feet wide, but just bring the heels a little closer in towards you. Next time the knees are tipped over to the right, let's pause there. Feet nice and wide. Maybe picking up your head and looking over the back arm. Again, lengthening the left fingertips away from you, dropping the weight into the left shoulder blade. An option to pick up your right foot, and lay it on top of the left knee. If that doesn't work for your hips, if that pulls your back, then please keep your feet on the floor, allowing that right knee to drop down. Let's take a couple of nice breaths there, breathing. Just wherever you feel that sensation of twist around the hip, the low back. Maybe into the neck if the head's turned. Bring the head back to center, unhook the foot, come back to center. Keeping the feet wide apart again, just resume that little tipping from side to side, little tick-tock. The knees. And then allow both knees just to tip over to the left. You can stay there or pick up the head, looking over the right arm, maybe picking up left foot rests on top of right knee. So try and relax that left knee down towards the floor rather than having it poking up towards the ceiling there. And remember, all of those options are suggestions. I can't come and adjust. I can't see necessarily everybody who might be struggling. So really taking that responsibility for your body today. Softening into that right shoulder blade. Lovely. And slowly head comes to center, unhook the foot. And let's bring both knees back to center. Walk heels back towards you. Just give your knees a little squeeze. You might want to roll, you might want to take your knees wide, almost do a little breaststroke with the legs there. The hips are felt, that lizard pose. I'm not sort of open hip postures today with our lizard, our warrior, so it's releasing any tension there. And if anyone does have to rush off, that's fine, but if you want to join me just to seal the practice with a few moments of Shavasana, just find a position where you can have most space in your body. That might mean for anyone with a low back issue, not having the legs outstretched, but keeping the feet on the floor
and the knees bent and locked together, that can sometimes release. I feel that sense of space in the low back, arms alongside you, or that traditional posture for Shavasana with the legs outstretched, the toes gently rolled out to the side, the heels in. So we've created that space across the front body. So when the movement is over, we've created a bit perhaps more space for our breath. And maybe throughout the practice, it's not just the body that benefits from that, it's that sense of carving out in the midst of what might be a very busy and frantic day or week, a little bit of space for ourselves. I'll take a moment just now to listen to those messages that the body is sending you, where you can perhaps adjust to create more sense of space. There's a lovely saying that yoga begins with listening. When we are listening, we are giving space to what is. So as you allow the breath again to become full and spacious, just paying heed to any intrusive thoughts that are less than spacious, constrictive, inhibiting. Acknowledging them, but letting them go. And using instead those words of space, expansiveness, and openness to pervade both the body and the mind. When you're ready, just begin to deepen the breath. It's creating even more space for each inhale and exhale. If you want to explore finding a full body stretch, just pausing with the arms gently back above the head or wide in a V shape. Just rest in there for a moment so you can just experience a few breaths, reaching into the space behind you, the space above you. When you're ready, just bringing the arms back down alongside you, bending your knees. You can bring your heels into your bottom. You can give your knees a little squeeze. You might want to just linger in the stillness at the end of a practice, or again, a little bit of movement, listening almost intuitively to where and what the body needs. And whether you've got space on the right-hand side or the left-hand side of you, it really doesn't matter. Just roll to lie on that side, just for a moment. And then come and join me in a comfortable position. Never has to be cross-legged, with the legs outstretched. Find a space across your sit bones, space lifting up and out of your hips. So you bring the hands into Anjali Mudra with the thumbs just resting in towards your breastbone. Lift your breastbone to meet your thumbs. Drop the shoulders and allow the chin just to drop ever so gently down towards your chest. So I feel we're living in a bit of a Ma moment, space and time in which we experience life. I'll just leave you with this lovely quote by an American author who wrote, "Honor the space between no longer and not yet." And I feel that's where we kind of are at the moment, aren't we? So namaste. Thank you for your practice. Let me come and unmute everybody for a minute.